What's up, guys? I am the best straight edge YouTuber in the world. But I'm not here to talk about CM Punk, but talk the Omega Kenny Omega. So I'm here to talk about the latest New Japan Wrestling pay-per-view, the two-night event, Dontaku. Let me tell you, there were some matches I didn't care about for night one. Night one, they had these amazing matches. They had the six-man with Naito's group, Los Moroches or something. I can't name the group, but Naito's team wins. Then we get to Cody versus Kobushi. That was an amazing match. Also, this is a spoiler, so warning, if you watch this video, don't watch it if you haven't seen Dontaku. But night one, Kota Ibushi versus Cody Rhodes. This match was amazing. Cody went through a table. His back was bleeding. Kota Ibushi did a freaking frog star splash out of midair in the crowd. Like, and then Cody won fair and square. He won the match. This match was a 5-star, man. Well, not 10, but 5 stars. Which is 5 out of 5, which it is a 10-star match. Then we get to, the Hangman, which is, Omega is in the main event for night one. He is against Hangman Page, so it's Bullet Club versus Bullet Club. And then freaking Kenny Omega came in there, knocked people out, and he has blonde hair now. He came in, knocked freaking Hangman, he freaking fought, they fought in battle. Cody tries to come after Omega, and then Omega just freaking drop kicks him, and then flies out for his Terminator Rise move, which I love. And then Omega rises up to the occasion, V trigger again, and then Hangman kicks out, and then he big triggers him in the mid air. And dude, it's all he wrote, but no, he kicks out, Hangman kicks out, and then he goes for another V trigger. Omega does. And then Omega hits that one laying angel. Boom. 1, 2, 3. Get out of here, Hangman. Omega wins. And Omega thanked the fans from night one. And he said, good night. Goodbye. And boom. Bang. Good night. I love that Tawny does. And then night two even got even better. Naito's group, you know, fought again. Naito fought against, I can't think who he faced. He faced somebody. And then, I think his group faced somebody. And then all of a sudden, Chris Jericho returns to New Japan and attacks Naito. He, like, takes him out. Naito was just walking around, and then Jericho disguised himself in a mask as one of his groups and then started beating him down, and he unmasked himself. And then Jericho got, you know, like a new shirt mocking Naito's group. Comes in there, bashes him, hitting with a code breaker, and then comes in and then bashes him, busts him open, and then beats everybody up, like, you know, because Jericho's heel in Japan, he's like the Alpha Omega. And then he goes in there, gets the ring bell, and knocks out Naito. Naito busts up bleeding, and he's sitting there pounding, saying, I'm the best. And then Naito gets mad, and he comes out in an interview, says, you know, he wants Jericho. Hopefully that happens at the big event, summer event in Dominion. Dominion's like the biggest Japan wrestling, New Japan wrestling pay-per-view. Can't wait for that. I hope they fight for the Intercontinental Champion, because Naito is the IWGP Intercontinental Champion. And then we get to, which this is night two, then we get to the freaking Will Ospreay versus, I can't think of this Japanese guy's name. He's like got a Back in the Future wrestling gimmick. And they put 205. You need to learn from New Japan Wrestling's cruiserweights. This cruiserweight junior was the IWGP junior, which is the cruiserweight championship match with Will Ospreay. This dude's insane. They went on and on. They did freaking amazing matches off rope. And then Will Ospreay comes up with this big old freaking move I've never seen before. Throws him up in the air and just grabs him by the neck and slams him on the ground. And then the other guy kicks out. And I'm like, oh my God, this is like a freaking... That match is a freaking 10-star match, all right. Best freaking cruiserweight title match I've seen in a long time in Japan. And, dude, like, he came out with, like, a top rope kind of RKO and then did his finisher, wheel spray, steel champ. And then all of a sudden, this dude comes out, and then there's a promo. We got a new Bullet Club member. Bullet Club. And all of a sudden, his Bone Crusher. And I'm like, who's Bone Crusher? And then we find out who he is. He's one of the top free agents. Oh, my gosh. And then he just attacks Will Ospreay. Oh, man. And Bullet Club for life takes over. And then we get to a six-man Bullet Club versus Bullet Club match. Leader versus old leader. This is night two. And then all of a sudden, you know, Omega, you know, he hits his V-trigger and all that. He goes against Cody, and then Cody runs off. And then so Omega chases Cody because they have a beef. And then, you know, all the other Bullet Club members go after each other. And then the Kenny Omega's team, the Bullet Club, ends up winning. They take out the Young Bucks, and I can't think of the other team, but dude, that match was sick. I'd give that and it's a tag match. I mean, and Kenny Omega's always, you know, gonna be a top star, so I give it a 10 out of 10. Oh man, and then we get to that was my other favorite match, and then we get to the main event, which is Okada versus Hiro Tanahashi, part 4, for the IWGP Heavyweight Championship. This match went on for 30 to 40 minutes long. They went back and forth, back and forth. Okada hit the tombstone out on the mat. Hiro Tanahashi hit a freaking frog splash out of the crowd into the crowd onto Okada. And then they fight fist back and forth, back and forth. And then freaking Tanahashi counters the freaking Rainmaker, not just once, not just twice, but three times. And then Okada comes back. He does his submission moves. Tanahashi gets out. And then they go back and forth, back and forth. And then Tanahashi at the very end freaking hit the Rainmaker. And then got the 1, 2, 3. And he's still the champ. He's the longest champ in New Japan. He's like 12 days. And not just after that, Okada says, after the show, who do I got next? Who do I need to face? Oh my God. He calls that. He's like, oh, I beat Kenny. Oh, can't do that. Oh, I beat Tanahashi. I've done that. He beat Will Ospreay. He's done that. I mean, he's beaten everybody in New Japan Wrestling. He's like the CM Punk of New Japan Wrestling. Like, for serious. Because there was one part in the match, he just took his foot and just disrespected Tanahashi. And he's like, I'm the best. And after the match, and then Kenny, he says, huh, why don't I call Kenny Omega? Omega comes out. The man. The wrestling god in New Japan Wrestling. He comes out, he says, how about we do no time limit, because last time they fought, they had a draw. And so, let's do no time limit. And so, he said, let's do something else. Let's do a 2 out of 3 falls. Not just that, for the IGW Heavyweight Championship, Kenny Omega, I think this is part 4 or part 5, June 9th at Dominion, the biggest New Japan Wrestling pay-per-view in the history in the summer, and also CM Punk's fight returning that night. We're gonna see Kenny Omega, Okada, one more time, 2 out of 3 falls, no time limit. This match is definitely going to be a 10 star, but this is gonna be a good freaking match. Kenny Omega in history versus Okada, Dominion. 2 out of 3 falls for the IGW Heavyweight Championship. I'm hoping Kenny Omega freaking wins this. And he will be the champ of the world and break Okada's record. Don't miss it. It's going to be good. Dominion, if you're New Japan Wrestling fans, if you're not, watch Kenny Omega. Go search him. He's amazing. That's all I got to say. And thank you for watching this video, guys. Give a thumbs up for a like. And hit that subscribe button. to the best straight edge YouTuber in the world.